big old baby.
What's that?
Viggo Mortensen. That's a man that's got a lifelong achievement award coming to him. Would you like one of these? Mango. Vitamin B. Oh. I think you'll be good in the movie. See, when Viggo played Lucifer in the movie The Prophecy, yes, he had guys like this crawling around behind him. Yeah, they wanted something. He'd say, ha! Vampire shit. Ha! There. That's it. But here we are. What's it mean? Nothing really. Just trying to lead something into a devil's night. Tonight. When that siren starts going off in the distance and we go running through the streets, because we're not going to sit and wait for people to attack, we're going to go make ourselves known. Right? Isn't that what you do? Don't sit there hiding in your house. You hide in your house, people will take your house. If you go running out into the public, they think you're with them. And you just move through, move through, move through. Watch your house. You see somebody coming at your house, you run out of the crowd and you say, pop, 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 pop. And all the people say, yeah, get that motherfucker. And you protect your house while protecting yourself. Devil's night. Tonight. Anything you ever remember of Devil's Night, baby? Nobody knows what Devil's Night is. Putting potatoes and mufflers and wax on windows and
toilet papering houses and all the terrible things kids do.
All I know is that Tim Roney ate that onion after we put a potato in a muffler and the cops caught us and he had an onion. So what are you doing with that onion? And Tim Roney said, eating it. And he looked at the cop and the cop looked at him and he started eating this onion raw. And he died of leukemia within 2 years.
That was that kid that died, right?
Yeah. Don't ever give in to a cop. Or don't eat raw onions. It's a confounded experiment. You don't know which one of it caused him to die of leukemia. Maybe it was just the cancer. Nobody ever liked him anyway. Devil's Night. Veil's thin. It's where everything's back and forth, and that's why we have All Saints Day on Monday, when Halloween is tomorrow. Tonight is the time for the good times. Yeah. Devil's Night. This is when all the bad souls show up. Funny how bad souls.
I didn't intend on it, but I just started watching all that stuff first thing in the morning. I don't know why.
Why?
I had forgotten that it was Devil's Night and all that stuff. I mean, obviously Halloween and all that, but
Devil's Night was a big deal.
Still watching.
They're trying to make us forget Devil's Night.
Samhain?
Samhain. Danzig stuff. Alexa, please play Danzig.
To just play songs by Danzig, You'll need to sign up for Amazon Music Unlimited Family Plan, which lets you play over 70 million songs on up to 6 accounts across multiple devices. It's free for 30 days and then you'll be automatically charged $14.99 a month. Cancel anytime. Terms in the Alexa app. Should I start your free trial and play music by dancing?
No!
Okay, I can play similar music instead for free. Here's a station for you based on dancing on Amazon Music.
Twist the King. Alexa, volume 10. That's my Danzig impression. Other than one where it's full down when I get knocked out, I haven't perfected that one. For some reason they can't hit me hard enough. This video will be demonetized. Stand in Hampton. That's British for a hard on. I got 52 subscribers. You want to be the 53rd? See, I didn't have to scream it like that because I sound just like them. I let them do the work. That's my secret. The boat. Same as Mike Muir does about me after he meets me. He's like, you're fucking with me, aren't you? No. He's never fucking with me. You're fucking with me, aren't you? I don't mind ya. Don't be so bad. Suicidal, baby. Mike Muir is gonna sue me now. I'm making him look bad. One person in the world goes up and starts talking shit about somebody everybody thinks they know about. They're like, all these people are like, wait a minute, what have I been missing? Suddenly, there's a loss. That's what makes me famous. Oh, I know this song. That's that guy in number 9. He probably looks a lot like me. I'm only doing this so we don't get demonetized. You just throw a little bit of sound over.
Demonic-tized.
Now it's all Hallows Eve.
It is. It's the 30th. Holy crap, I'm gonna shut up.
Will she trick or treat?
I've never listened to words of this song. I had no idea it was a Halloween song. I didn't even ask for it. Tell anybody to be quiet right now.
Sorry, I'm not sure.
Alexa, does courtesy work?
Here's something I found on the web. According to fixia.com, the courtesy door lights work, but the front and rear roof mount courtesy lights do not. Did that answer your question?
Pretty close.
Yes. What that tells me is...
Thanks for your feedback.
That you might look good up front, but if out back, you're armed and loaded. You're not welcome. The lights aren't quite right out back.
Loving you, loving the day, loving you.
I never loved anybody that was ever alive. And so to love you, like loving the dead, those are the people I look to. Those are the people I admire. Those who have gone before us, who are done business. I love you like I love the dead. You are perfection and content and joy and lust. You are... What would you want with the dead other than lust? Something you can't have that just lures you and says, ah, but here we are. Loving you is like loving the dead. I feel like there is something about today and tomorrow and just all this stuff, you know, where they say that Halloween is 12 days, like the 12 days of Christmas before and after, 6 and 6, 5 and a half, 5 and a half and 1. I don't know how it works out to make 12, but they say Halloween, that whole...
I know the energy is very intense. I can feel it.
So,
with people, you know?
If you keep putting your face on the way they know your face, they're gonna get you. Sometimes it's just right to wash it all off and let yourself be seen, right? Just let them look. Let them fear. Let them see the truth of a fucking human being standing there with its fucking teeth. Back off. 6 feet. Do you have anything you want me to say before we go? Do you have anything? Imagine if you wanted to direct me down a road, what would you throw out there? Imagine that you believed you could make me say something without me knowing it was you saying it, but me, like an idea. You got any ideas?
I think you should lead us.
Now that's a dangerous thing to talk about. And she thinks I should lead us.
Don't worry, don't worry.
She means this. We got enough people right now coming up with ideas that are totally outside of the box. Seeing how this whole fucking place is falling apart. Seeing how here in the time of Samhain, when the veil is lifted and we can see between life and death, for some odd reason, we're able to see between societal life and death at the same time. We are seeing how politics has been askew for so long and how it's just followed some simple fucking path that somebody said, this is going to be the way it goes, and this is the way it goes, and this is the way it goes. Nobody's come up with another way around it. They're just like, okay, we're part of the system and we're going to fail in another 200 years. And here, oh, it's the time. And we let it go and we let it die. And all of a sudden, we're all just walking as insects as we were to begin with. Just when we're opening our real eyes, we're about to become insects again if we let those people tell us. But what do? We have to look into what everybody is saying out there with their crazy ideas about how things are going to be better. And these people that are coming up with crazy ideas are nerds. And I've always said about nerds, I would rather have a nerd for a friend than you. Because at least a nerd knows what the fuck they're talking about. They're seeking a truth because they've been punished for being a nerd for so long. They need to know why it is. They're looking for realities that just jocks don't see. So you take the nerds. They're coming up with ideas. But they're not going to be a lead. They need somebody that can play a game of soccer with a bunch of 10-year-olds and walk away without a hospitalization. They need somebody that's a good shot. They need somebody that really means what they have to say. You say I should lead? It's time we ask the Batman to take his mask off.